In this segment of the Word tutorial for Microsoft 365, we are going to learn how to do an envelope mail merge. So we have a list of customers and we want to create envelopes with every person's address. We can do that by using an Excel data file, and this data file, you can generate it from other systems that have a database of some sort. If you have a database, you can extract the data for the mail merge into Excel. The key here is that the first row needs to include the label names for each of the columns or each of the fields. In that way, we'll use them as part of the mail merge process. Notice that it's only one sheet in this worksheet, and typically it'll be just sheet one. I have it customers in the bottom. Now, to create a mailing for envelopes, go to the Mailings tab and then click on Start a Mail Merge and then select Envelopes. It's going to prompt us what do we want to use for the delivery address, which will fill it up with the fields, the merge fields in a moment. And then it's going to utilize your return address with your own return address. So we click OK to this. And then we need to select the recipients. Under Select Recipients, we are going to use an existing list, and we are going to point to that Excel file that I showed a moment ago. Then we click on Open, and then Yes, and then we are going to use the whole spreadsheet. We click OK. Next, we can filter the recipients, where you can specify particular fields, such as a state or the zip code, and that only a specific state should be included in this mailing. For now, I'm going to leave that off. Then under the address field, we insert the merge fields. Click here on merge field, and then pick the first name. Notice it's kind of coded, but behind the scenes, the system is going to pull everybody's name automatically based on these label definitions or those field names. Then we put the last name and then new line. We could also put both of these next down here. Then we put in the address, then the city, the state, and then the zip. Next, we go to preview results and then navigate through each one of those records. Once we are ready to print them out, click here on finish. I do suggest, however, that you click Edit Individual Documents to first verify that all the addresses look correct and then print them. In that way, you don't waste your envelopes. If we click here on Edit Individual Documents, notice it has generated all the envelopes. It should be 38 or 39 of them. Now, this Edit the Results page, you don't need to save it unless you need it for documentation purposes. However, this Forms page, and I'll turn off the Preview Results option here, this you can save it so that in the future you can update your list of data from Excel, add a new name and so on, and then you can return to rerun this at any point. You click here on Yes, click OK, and then you can rerun it by going to Mailings, and then if you click to preview the results, it will rerun the whole mail merge with all the contacts. So basically, the form you reuse, the data file, you keep it up to date, and the merge results, you don't need it unless you want to keep it for documentation purposes.